I was just watching a video last night of one that my friend Dave Kelso made while I was staying with him and his family in Chicago. And it was quite funny because I was going back and looking at the things that I said and listening to what I was saying back then, back when I was around this like really awesome bunch of people who were super high energy and really all for, you know, making what they have to offer known to the world, and what kind of impact that had on me, being a person who was very shy of being self-promoting. I mean,
but anyway, so what ends up happening is, you know, I'm taking video around the restaurant. There's like this flaming cheese we got the video of, like, you know, like 2 foot flame on the thing, igniting the brandy and everything. I'll just talk about, yeah, you know, just, I'll be honest, you know, I'm just, we're taking some video and we're going to put it online and advertise your store. And, you know, I'm going to be making money on YouTube by having this video. And all of a sudden it catches the interest of the owner.
But I was just starting to really come out of my shell more and feel more comfortable with sharing what I had to offer the world. For a long time, I had just shared my paintings and things like that on Facebook, and I was just tipping my toes in the water, and I was sort of okay with it, but I never really actively like told people what I was doing. I never actually made it known to the world, hey, this is what I'm about, hey, come check me out, here's my website links, you know, follow me, both.
You know, she's got an awesome YouTube account, too. If you do a YouTube search just for keywords Katerina Edwards, you'll find her.
Alrighty, sounds good. I'll give you a few moments.
Thank you, appreciate it. Thank
blah, blah, blah. You know, I felt very uncomfortable with that because there was a part of me that felt very, very uncomfortable.
So weird.
And you aspire to be just
it's
as random.
It's not my style.
So the owner's walking up and he ends up like paying for some of our food. He's like, oh, no charge, it's cool. So then he wants me to help him get some online stuff going for his website because he's like an older guy and online illiterate. And then, you know, he's like, oh, Katerina, next time you're in Chicago, you know, you gotta do some photography for my store and all this. And and it's like, yeah, Katerina was blown away. She just, you know, couldn't believe.
Because I had low self-esteem and very low self-worth. Even though I was this great artist, even though I had all of these great writings and everything like that, there was still part of me that felt like what I had to offer to the world didn't really matter. So why bother? Why share anything with them? Because they're just gonna poo-poo it anyway.
That has to get me over my freaking video fear. The fact that I'm on a webinar with all you right now is like massive.
Really?
Go for it.
Oh, what did I learn?
What did you get?
What we're talking about here.
You know, that was my belief system, and that kept me in a very small box. One that said, you cannot leave this box. This is your confined space. You can have to navigate within this space.
Push you out on the ledge.
I'm just encouraging you to step out of your box. Be a little more spontaneous. I know, your box is telling me to go screw myself right now.
Yeah, it is.
That's okay.
If people come to you and tell you your paintings are great, that's okay. That's acceptable. But if you go out there and tell somebody that, hey, this is what I'm doing, you know, you're telling me about your business stuff, I can tell you about my business stuff. That was off limits.
Well, I was already talking about how you're my best friend and how awesome you are, so I just
simply messaged you. She has a YouTube channel, check her out.
Huh?
I don't do that.
Because I passed up many opportunities to make painting sales, or I passed up many opportunities for people to come to me and ask for paintings because they had no idea I was even an artist. You know, that's why when I first came onto the internet, back when I was about 13 years old, I started messing around with social media. I had like this presence online. where I could be a little bit more verbose and a little bit more out there and more promoting, because it wasn't actually my physical words that had to come out of my mouth to speak and tell people, hey, this is who I am. There was just this web sphere for me to broadcast that, and aside from that, I would be in my life and I would be this quiet girl who wouldn't say anything, wouldn't disturb anybody.
And there's another section of that's going to be in the video too, as far as like when Katerina really starts to lighten up and it's, you know, outside of the restaurant. It's like, you know, when we were waiting like at the bus stop and stuff, and she just got really silly. This will be included in the video, but you're not going to be able to see it right this second. But I want to play a little bit of the audio just so you could see how lightened up she got. It's going to be pretty apparent here.
Mind you, I'm wearing his hat, like, backwards. I'm standing on a bench at a bus stop. Like, we'll show. It was just retarded. And I'm saying this shit, like, in public.
Maybe a couple of garden shovels.
Hey, so all of you out crazy that, okay?
It won't be hard.
It won't be hard. I'm still, seriously, at this point, I'm still sitting there with, like, this cap sideways now.
Oh, yeah, wait till you see it. You're going to love this shit.
I'm looking for it right now.
You're going to make so much money off that video.
See, that's the thing that I didn't really understand until today. That's why Dave does all this stupid shit that, like, I never really understood. And I was always like, but that's not politically correct. That's kind of stupid, Dave.
That's brilliant.
I would
go
down.
Video.
Go for it.
No, what did I learn?
What did you learn?
I don't know what we're talking about here.
But as I'm getting older, I'm realizing that the two really need to merge. You know, that web identity is a true identity for you, but that needs to be broadcast in your daily life too.
People will just start coming to you.
When you're out and talking.
It's really random.
Oh, I have an idea.
I know. That's one of the great things about it.
That's just my paradigm of where I'm at right now.
That's okay. Like I said, I'm being encouraging.
You don't need to sit there and be like, hey, join my business, blah, 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 blah. Hey, buy my paintings, blah, 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 blah. But that confidence, that level of, here I am, this is who I am, you deserve to know about it because I think it's pretty cool and I want to know about your stuff too. That is where true connections can be formed and true networking can form. When we're keeping ourselves a secret and hiding ourselves under this little bushel, nobody's ever going to want to do anything with us because they don't know about us. And then anytime that we try to interject something into there, they're just going to think that we're like creepy scammers or something, or that we're just trying to sell them a painting that they don't even really want to buy anyway because they don't even have a relationship with us. Why would they want to buy a painting from us if they don't even know who we are or what motivated us to make it? People really want to know who you are, and that's something that I'm really seeing, is people want to connect.
There's a video that I uploaded like 48 hours ago, and it's already got like in excess of 300 views and over 14 comments and shit like that.
Okay, guys, model the crazy. I think we got somebody. We got a out crazy.
Yeah. You know what? Watch my video, share them around, and I dare y'all to out crazy me.
I accept that.
You will see just what kind of a challenge it is.
It's really hard to beat this kind of crazy.
Go for it.
No, what did I learn?
What did you learn?
I don't know what we're talking about here.
A painting is just a symbol of a person, just other realms. Perception, you know, that a painting is one small little version of the bigger whole of the human being that created it. And with a business, you know, it's just one little fraction of a person and who they are, and people want to know who that person is so they can better understand what this little business model is. Do you know what I'm saying? There are reasons for us to want to be self-promoting, and not in a negative, egotistical way, not in a, oh, look at me, I have the greatest deal since sliced bread kind of way. It's about people connecting to people, and that's really what it is at the end of the day.
Yeah, like for example, one thing I'm into is polarity integration, which means recognizing light and dark as frequencies and integrating them instead of having all these stupid judgments. And there's this one I did
with
a friend. It's called Morning Wood.
From the same folks who brought you Viagra, now there's Big Johnson & Johnson's Morning Wood.
Look at his face.
I look like the V-mask, but without the mask, you know?
Just do it again. So I can take a good picture.
Creepy.
That was really scary when the flash comes out of his face.
It looks like the Nightmare Before Christmas, honestly.
It does! That's what I'm saying. It's just so creepy looking.
Yeah. But like I was saying, there's this one video I did. It's called Morning Wood. You know, this is like totally spontaneous. Like me, this dude, Chris, my dad, and our other friend, we were out in the backyard and, you know, just chilling and whatever, drinking some beers, whatever. And there was like this piece of wood that I had out there, and we were just like joking around. He's talking about, oh yeah, morning wood. So I like take this piece of wood and I write with marker. I put like just a little dick on it, and I'm like, Chris's morning wood. And he
every man has
like grabs the wood, and he's just like, you know, like sticking it down by his crotch and doing it like it's some sort of like Vidal Sassoon freaking photo op. And like, you know, Connie starts coming around, leaning down, taking pictures and shit.
Every man has morning wood, but I'm the only one proud enough to carry it.
Every man.
With me wherever I go.
Every man should be proud to display their morning wood in their daily routine.
I wouldn't tell what about my morning wood? Hell no, I'm proud of it. I'll even show it to my nieces, my nephews.
He's like, women love my morning wood, you know.
Most women admire the courage of men who are proud to present to them their morning wood.
Connie, you like my morning wood?
I love your morning wood.
Say, look at that.
The girls love morning wood. Also brought to you in part by Dick Insider. Every woman loves a little Dick Insider now and then.
And just like, it's just like crazy, you know, like I got that up on there. And
go for it.
No, what did I learn?
What did you know yet?
I don't know what we're talking about here.
Because if you know me, it's no secret that I am a part of this really awesome business. And it's been helping me develop and grow myself, my internet marketing skill sets, my know-how, my knowledge. It's helping my art business, all these things, and it's very positive for me to be a part of. And so I have no shame in promoting it because I want you to know about it too. I think it's really awesome. And
look at that. They're totally, this used to be the playground over here. They are just totally, looks like they're doing some work here too. Are they putting it so? Okay. You'll be able to in a moment, because we're approaching an open field section. Yeah, this park is beautiful. We're moving over to the more scenic section of it right now. Cool. Well, that was good. Look at those trees. Beautiful flower trees. Katerina's across the street getting change. Katerina at Midwest Fine Cell playing a little ukulele thingy. Host an event party. Yoo-hoo. Party time.
I have to learn how to tune them, because that's been my problem. My one at home is all out of tune, but I don't have like the right tuning ups or sound, whatever things for them. So it's been halting my progress.
I have no freaking idea, actually. You'd have to ask Wayne, because I have no idea what this is.
Hey, what is this?
That's funny, Jack cleaned out real nice for me.
Hey, Wayne?
Yes, sir.
Well, what is this thing?
Lap steel, like for sliding the car. You use a big, like, metal bar.
She plays a little bit of ukulele. She's just trying to learn how to tune guitar stuff because she hasn't figured out the trick
ukulele
to tune.
Like,
you
need,
should
like,
just get a like
cups?
20-hour tuner that hooks to your headstock. They call them a snark. Mm-hmm. They tune everything. They really boom, boom, boom.
Do you have one? Yeah, I want to check this out. I want to see it. The robins are getting a little curious, it seems. That one right there keeps getting closer. Hello, Robin. Where's Batman? There's Catwoman. Katerina.
This is as long as you know what keys you're in, these things. You hook them to your headstock.
Cool.
So I have a guitar tuner, but I was just wondering how that translates over to a ukulele.
Right. Well, these are chromatic, so they're going to work on a uke. You know, see, like, I don't know if you can see. See how it's E? You know, I can't even see it now.
Yeah.
But D, you know, it'll tune to whatever, you know, your uke is. If it's D, G, A, just hit it, and it'll get there for you. They're the coolest things. We sell a lot of them. Everybody's got them.
Because it can be loud, and you can still tune it because it's working. Like a lot of acoustics, it's like, everyone's got to be quiet.
And if your guitar tuner is chromatic, your guitar tuner, if it's chromatic, it should work too. But
yeah.
You know, ukuleles are nylon strings. You got to stretch them. Once you get them in a tuner, okay for, you know, but.
So this should work on a ukulele without a problem.
Well, these will, yeah, they're chromatic. There's a uke back there if you want to try one of these.
Okay.
Want to try one? I don't know if you can reach. Oh, yeah, there's one on the bottom.
Even more flower trees. Well, this neighborhood just keeps looking better and better, all the flower trees and shit. It's cool. Well, Wayne, seeing as this is going on YouTube, why don't you state the name of your place and the address and everything so people know where to go to get a snark?
Buy and sell. 6019 West Irving Park Road.
6019 West Irving Park Road?
Correct.
Midwest Buy and Sell. What's your phone number?
Best kept secret. 773-545-2020.
And your website?
It's MidwestBuyAndSell.com.
All right, cool. So now people know where to go. If they want one of them awesome snarks or any of this awesome freaking array, yeah, there's Katerina with her snark. Show us your snark, baby. Ooh, sexy snark. Okay, look at all this. Just there's so much stuff, and you know you can't beat the deals around here. And he's really picky about quality, so you know you're getting some good shit if you go to Midwest Buy and Sell. He will not settle for bullshit. So absolutely. Freaking awesome. Look at this tree. That is a beautiful flower tree. Another one on the other side there too. Wow. It's freaking awesome. I wish those trees would stay like that all year long. That's just awesome. There's another flower tree. I have no idea what that one is. Crazy. Look at all these guitars and stuff they got around here too. I mean, this is a massive, massive music store. PV amplifiers, professional keyboards. I mean, they got guitars literally hanging from the ceiling here. Amps from like the 50s and 60s all the way up to the most modern professional keyboards. They got freaking everything. Little hole-in-the-wall shop. You'll miss it if you blink, but man, you come in and it opens up into an expanse of musical awesomeness. Go for it.
No, what did I learn?
What did you... Oh, yeah.
I don't know what we're talking about here.
decided I think I'm just going to leave it on. And when I get comfortable with the fact that there is something staring at me, recording my every movement, then maybe I'll be able to talk. Yeah, Dave?
You weren't supposed to know about those cameras that the government put in your luggage.
No pressure, no pressure, no pressure. Can you go on the other side and make sure that it's actually facing me?
That it's defacing you?
Not defacing, but, you know, like, properly... properly aligned to my head. That would be good! Oh, I have an idea.
You might want to scooch back a little.
How about we talk?
If the top of this camera was a ceiling, it would be only a couple inches till you were bumping your head on it. So you still might want to scooch back a little. Now let me see if I can... No, we're all the way zoomed out. Okay, now the ceiling is about 6 inches above your head, perspective-wise.
Perfect.
In accordance to the prophecy.
So do I introduce you or something? Or do I introduce
Now what us? We have here is the brown Canadian ground squirrel. And they eat vegetarian pizza.
Vegetarian pizza. I just like vegetables on my pizza.
Well, then I guess you'd love my dad's brain on your pizza, because that's about as vegetable as it gets.
What's so funny about vegetables being in your dad's head?
Nah, I guess you're right.
Maybe it's coleslaw?
Pointing out the obvious isn't always funny.
It's like having to get used to a friend, like, staring at you all the time. That's literally what having a camera on you is like. Watching everything.
Well, my family's always been camera whores, so I guess I can't relate in that regard, because I'm used to cameras.
Well, that's good. Everybody...
Oh, look, the ice cream person. That particular ice cream vendor... they have some of the best ice cream. Like, they have, like, coconut ice cream made out of real coconut and strawberry ice cream made out of real strawberry. Huh?
I like your bike!
They have the best ice cream. They really do. Whereas, like, if you buy a strawberry or coconut ice cream in the store down the street or something, it's probably going to be imitation crap. Those ice cream bars have the real thing.
He looked happy. He's eating real ice cream.
Nah.
That's the face of a real ice cream eater. Yeah.
You know how else you can tell real ice cream? Ah! I screamed. And it was real. You just weren't expecting that.
No!
You jumped like a mile out of your skin. Like,
I know.
You see, that's how Bashar teaches people how to levitate. You were like off the ground like an inch just a second.
Oh, funny, funny, Dave. Personal development day.
Katerina's a lot more happy now. Because this is no longer shoved up her ass.
And you want to know what helped me not have a shovel up my ass?
You saw that Bashar said,
if you really want enlightenment, then just lighten up.
And it was so plainly obvious to you that you instantly took the coupon? that was not easy. You didn't make it that easy.
I think
easy.
Everyone tries to make personal development into, like, this big, scary task, and, like this big feat of impossible incredulity, and it was just like, oh, I have to develop myself, and they have, like, you know, whips and chains, and I have to develop myself.
Ain't nobody got time for that.
Yeah, there's some aspects.
Ass. Pecked.
Of it, you know, like if you're wanting to learn more about finances and stuff like that, that you gotta be a little bit more diligent about. You're not gonna just magically, like, know stuff. But
instead of the natural flow, they treat it like this viral culture that needs to be developed in the sterile environment, corporate environment. Go to school and get brainwashed, motherfucker. You're our bitch.
Basically. But I think that in terms of, like, actual lasting personal development, it needs to be based in a fun, you know, lightened up atmosphere. You know, just taking things a little bit less heavily and seriously.
Yeah, silly is the gateway to the serious. You need silly to get to the serious. Otherwise, what you have is what I refer to as constipation of the brain. How can any information flow efficiently if you're full of shit, basically?
Basically. And personal development is one of those things that if you want to let it flow into your mind and really take hold of the concepts...
You have to be brave enough to realize when you're full of shit.
Yes,
so that you can flush.
So you can flush.
Because, you know, we don't flash, we flush.
So you can get rid of all of the crazy blocks that are keeping you from living the way that you really want to and living in that. So
you can evict the fence witches.
So you can
synchronistic fence witch eviction, oh yeah.
Basically.
And people on the Empower Network are watching this now and going, the hell's a fence witch?
Oh, Dave, self-promotion slipped into the Empower Network video.
Just use Google.
YouTube fence witch, if you're curious about what a fence witch is.
That's another way to liberate yourself and develop yourself. There's fence witches everywhere, and you can use the nearest fence witch to basically manifest your abundance through your joy by removing judgment and having fun when a fence witch tries to absolutely freaking destroy you and annihilate you because they're scum of the earth. You can just see shit as fertilizer and plant your garden. And fence witches really hate gardens.
Yes. Yeah. Obviously. They want to suck the life out of everything.
I ain't begging your pardon, but if you got a garden, then you gotta know there's some shit I'll be starting. I have all that ripped out and put in some fences. And if I was in Section 8, I'd also cement it.
But I myself had a couple of my own personal fence switches. But it's not necessarily something that you need to, you know, smash you to pieces, as Dave said, you know, he's talking about using it as a method of moving more into your joy and empowerment and abundance. And
isn't it interesting how very synchronistically and unexpectedly one of your fence witches apologized to you?
Yeah, I didn't have to do anything. I just kept staying aligned with myself and in my joy and doing things that I wanted to do, and regardless of whether or not they thought I was being crazy or new agey or whatever.
The next Empower Network blog. Just kidding.
I still kept learning and developing myself and doing it in the way that I saw fit and the way that was fun for me.
Whether you believe in metaphysics or not, I think it's pretty common sense that it's almost impossible to do anything with this up your ass. Okay. It's a no-brainer here. If that's up your ass, you're going to have difficulty.
Yeah. So lose the shovel. And start living a little bit more. And
You want to do that again, Mike?
Out of your butt. Have fun.